Tourism authorities say the formula employed for the first half of the year to deal with the economic challenges and maintain the competitive edge in the tourist industry has worked. But Tourism Minister Lawn Theophilus says the sector will not rest on its laurels as it looks forward to reaping more benefits from the rebranded Saint Lucia Jazz and Arts Festival.
It shows that from the numbers that we saw this year, the record numbers, that clearly that not just Saint Lucians but persons within the region and the wider world have embraced the idea that we've embarked upon, something that we intend to build on as we are currently planning the Jazz and Arts Festival for 2014. It's going to be a tall order because I know expectations will be high based upon what they've seen from 2013. But the numbers would reflect that the experiment has worked, not just in terms of the numbers to the destination, but in terms of this gel or fusion between tourism and the creative industries.
The minister also reported increases in visitor arrivals during the carnival celebration. He says about 2,000 French visitors converged on St. Lucia's shores for the event. Stayover arrivals increased by 5%, but there was a 7% decline in cruise arrivals due to what officials describe as some difficulties encountered by the main volume producers.
And you'd be very familiar with some of the issues with regards to cruise globally. And although we have an increase in the number of cruise calls, the load factors for the vessels have not been as strong as they had been in the past. So we've seen a decline to some extent in that category of arrivals. Having said so, when we look at the cruise schedule for the next year, for the season beginning in October, we have confidence that we could see as much as a 14 to 15% increase in arrivals. So with regard to that market, the future looks relatively bright. We continue to promote the destination very actively, and we do it in close collaboration with our airline partners. The minister mentioned the fact that we have the new United service that has come on board. The first three flights have been at 100% capacity.
A three-day wedding symposium has been planned for St. Lucia. Some 70 travel agents are expected to attend the event, which will be held at the Sandals Resort.
We know that there is still work that needs to be done, and how are we going to do that is really to set ourselves apart by having this Love Elevated Wedding Symposium with speakers from places like The Knot, Destination Weddings and Honeymoons, Hitch.com from the UK. Those are major bridal, weddings, honeymoons, publications, media outlets, and very strong in these markets. And with them coming on board with us, at no cost to the St. Lucia Tourist Board, whereby they're not actually charging us to come and be a speaker. So we have a full day of seminars, and from topics ranging from how can you improve the service, how telling them about St. Lucia and what St. Lucia has to offer, and also really telling the travel agents and our local suppliers how can you improve what you do to attract more weddings from overseas.
There will also be a Shakespeare event slated for August 23rd and 24th. St. Lucia will be the only Caribbean island where the show will be held. The St. Lucia Tourist Board will be embarking on a marketing campaign to promote the event. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.